Happy Sunday, everyone. Today we're going to be talking about Elijah on Mount Carmel. On Mount Carmel. And it's taken from 1 Kings, which is in the Old Testament, and the chapter is 18. All right, let's listen. God sent Elijah far away. After a time, God told Elijah, "Go and speak to Ahab." When Ahab met Elijah, Ahab said, "Is that you, the one destroying Israel?" Elijah said, "You and your family are the destroyers. You have followed false gods. Gather the people to meet me at Mount Carmel. Call the 450 prophets of Baal and the 400 prophets of Asherah who serve Queen Jezebel." See, those were false prophets serving false gods. King Ahab gathered the Israelites and the prophets of false gods. Elijah asked the people, "How long until you decide? If God is the true God, follow him. If Baal is a god, follow him." The people did not answer Elijah. Elijah said, "I am the only prophet of the Lord, but Baal's prophets are many. Bring two bulls to sacrifice. Prepare one of them, place it on the wood, but do not light the fire. I will do the same with the other bull. Then call on the name of your God, and I will call on the name of the Lord. The one who answers and sends fire, he is God." The prophets of Baal prayed, "Baal, answer us." They shouted from morning until noon, but there was no answer. All afternoon, the people prayed to Baal. Still, there was no sound. No one answered. Then Elijah told the people to gather near him. He took 12 stones and built an altar. Then he made a trench around the altar to hold water. He arranged the wood, prepared the bull, and placed it on the wood. Elijah said, "Fill 4 water pots with water and pour it on the bull and the wood." Elijah told the helpers to pour water, on the altar 2 more times. Soon, water ran all around the altar and filled the trench. In the early evening, Elijah came to the altar and prayed, "Lord, today, let it be known that you are God and I am your servant. Answer me so that the people will know that you, the Lord, are God." God did. Fire burned the offering, the wood, the stones, and the water. It burned the water, y'all. The people cried, "The Lord, he is God. The Lord, he is God." What I want you to know today is that we serve the one true God. He is the God in heaven. He is the God that created all things. He created the universe. He created the earth. He created you and me. Everything that you see, God created with either his hands, which with people, or with his mouth that he spoke it. We should not put other things in front of God. We should not worship people. We should not worship things. The only person that we bow down before is God and his son, Jesus, who is ruler. There can be many distractions and things that try to take our eyes off of God. And there are a lot of voices that try to make us believe that they're in control of things. But God is the only one who is in control. He is the only one that we pray to because he alone has the power to do all things. I want you all to be encouraged to know that God is in control and he is the one true God. Let's pray. Dear Lord, we thank you for this day. Thank you for being the one true God, the God that holds the world in his hands. Lord, I pray that you would continue to protect us that you'll continue to lead us and to guide us. Give us wisdom and discernment. Help us to know your voice. Help us become more like you. We love you, we thank you, and we praise you. Help us to see where you are at work, Lord, so that we may join you, God. In Jesus' name we pray. Amen. All right, I hope you all have a wonderful week. I hope to see you on Wednesday for Bible study and crafts and snacks on Saturday. All right, bye.